Hey, hi, hello, YouTube. It's your boy DeviDubz, and we are back with another video. Welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel. If you've been here before, get comfy, grab a snack, grab a blanket, grab a pillow, sit down, get comfy. Billie Eilish is dropping her second studio album titled Happier Than Ever. Listen, I don't really got nothing to say. All I'm gonna say is follow me on my social medias. They're right here and linked in the description below. Like this video. Just go ahead and like it already. Just go ahead and like it. And then subscribe if you haven't done that. And then turn on the post notification bell. I don't want to waste no time. Here we go with Happier Than Ever. Track number one. Track number one is Getting Older.
I'm getting older. I think I'm aging well. I wish someone had told me I'd be doing this by myself. Which is ironic, because the strangers seem to want me more than anyone before. Last week.
I really like the simplicity in that, in the chord progression. Those three notes. I like it. Like, it's real simple. It's starting to build up.
Everything sounds worse. Can't shake the feeling that I'm just bad at healing. When I wasn't honest, I was still being ignored. Looking for attention. Things I once enjoyed just keep me employed now.
Oh no, you got a bass.
At least that's my endeavor, to keep myself together and put my decision to be abused. Just keep me employed now.
That's sad to hear, because she's not having fun with it anymore.
I've had some trauma, did things I didn't wanna. Was too afraid to tell ya, but now I think it's time.
I feel like that was a really good intro. I like that she chose this song to be the intro, because she's literally telling us things that she's experienced, and as an artist and a person in the public eye, the things she's gone through, and she's about to tell us even more with this album. I really feel like this is about to be like so much more mature than When We All Fall Asleep, Where Do We Go. But I feel like we're about to hear a lot of new things that are gonna either be shocking, or things that we didn't know, or things that we suspected but didn't, you know, like stuff like that. Like, I feel like she's gonna, simply put, I feel like this album is gonna be like a journal, basically, and we're about to read it. Okay, I'm done rambling. Here we go with track number two, I Didn't Change My Number. A monster? Come on.
I didn't change my number. I only changed who I replied to. Don't take it out on me. I'm out of sympathy.
Come on.
For you. Maybe you don't deserve to feel so hurt. You got a lot of fucking nerve.
You don't deserve to feel so hurt.
So take it out on you. And your best friend too. I should have left when
that was cute. Okay, I like this one. I like her energy in these newer songs. Like, it's like she's giving off a vibe of like, I'm not dealing with nobody's bullshit no more. If you got a problem, then let's talk about it. Let's get into it. Because, you know, I'm about to go off on you. And I think in this song, she said, I'm going to go off on your friends too. Like, she said something like that. And I just like this energy. Like, she ain't really dealing with nobody in their mess no more. Like, kick them to the curb. She said, I didn't change my number. I changed who I believe in. So she's just changing her perspective on people. She changed her mentality. She bossing up. Also, I can tell that with this album, we're going to hear a lot of different sounds. I feel like before, just her and Phineas were already good with, you know, making their songs sound unique. But like, I feel like they're about to be really unique when it comes to the production of this album. Anyways, track number three, Billie Bossa Nova.
Love when it comes without a warning. cause waiting for it gets so boring. A lot can change in 20 seconds, or check-ins. It's hard to stop it once it starts.
I knew that that was coming. I didn't know how she was going to do it exactly, but I'm so happy that she did it. In my head, I was thinking, because I'm looking at the lyric, and like for some reason, listening to the song, listening to the lyrics, and listening to the production, I thought there was going to be a little break, and then she was going to go into her falsetto. I thought it was going to be like a, I'm not sentimental. Like, I thought she was going to be up there, and that's exactly what she did. My mind, it just, como se dice, brilliant.
Look your phone and look at me when you're alone. Won't take a lot to get you going. Nobody saw me in the lobby. Nobody saw me in your arms.
Come on.
The only one who doesn't know you like. You better lock your phone.
Oh my god, this is a banger. It's not even a, usually a banger is like a super upbeat heavy bass, but like when I say banger, I just mean like the song is good. This chorus is sick. I really like it. I like how she's been like real like seductive. Like, you better lock your doors. It don't take much to get you going. Like, I like this. This might actually be my new favorite song so far. I mean, we only on track 3, but I think this might be my favorite so far. I want to go back to the beginning of this chorus.
And look at me when you're alone. Until you better lock your door.
Hey!
And look at me a little more. I'm not sentimental. I'm not sentimental.
Billie Bossa Nova is a banger. Yeah. Track number 4, My Future. This was like the first lead single. Like, this was like a single before it even became a lead single, I think, because I feel like Therefore I Am, I thought that was like the lead single, but My Future came out a long periodically time ago. We still gonna listen to a little bit of it. Let's do it.
I can't seem to focus, and you don't seem to notice. Somebody else just wanna get to know myself.
I always overlook this song because of the beginning, because of how slow it is, but then I remember that it picks up and I remember liking it more. But for some reason, I'm like naturally not drawn to it simply because of the beginning. But here we go with track number 5, Oxytocin. Oxytocin. I think it's Oxytocin. Oh, bass. She better eat this one up.
Can't take it back once it's been set in motion. Only pray on Sunday. Could you come my way on Monday? Cause I liked it. She'd wanna get involved, involved, involved. And what would people say? People say, people say. If they listen.
So far, I'm not really feeling it because it's one of those like talky, whispery type of songs. It's less singy and more, you know, like just talking. It's not bad. I think the only reason that it's not as bad to me is because it is upbeat, and this is one of the first upbeat songs that we've had on the album, so that kind of saves it. But I feel like vocally, it's not really my favorite, but it may pick up, so let's keep going. I like this bass though.
Oxytocin,
okay.
If you find it,
this song is like real seductive and like sexual too. Like, you can hear like the heavy breaths and the moans in the background, and like her lyrics. She said, I want to do bad things to you. Like, she said, I'm a grown woman.
I
All right, we just got done listening to Oxytocin, and to be honest, it wasn't really my favorite. The thing I liked most about it was probably the production. I wasn't too pleased with the vocals or just the way she went about the song. As of right now, I have to say that this is my least favorite. I do like the lyrics. Like, I like that she's, you know, getting into her sexual bag. She's giving us a different side, because I feel like she didn't talk about this stuff before. She was still considered like a child or a kid. So now she's older and she can talk about this stuff and feel confident talking about it. And I like that. But it just, I feel like it wasn't executed in that song. Here we go. Track number 6, Goldwing. She giving church. Choir. It is really pretty though. Ooh, I heard a stutter. Come on, beat. Wait. Hold on. No, I'm going back. Like I said, her production will always hit. What? She's so sick, because while you listen to this front line in the background, she's still giving you that going, going. She's still doing it, and it sounds so sick. Yeah. I'm in awe of this song. I don't like the "you better keep your head at it." Like the way she stuttered and had like other sections come in. Hold on, I'm gonna go back so y'all can hear it. Keep your head at it. Like that part. This one was too short. Everything about this one was so sick. She gave you some vocals. She gave you those harmonies. She gave you lyricism. The production. Like I knew that this album was going to be production heavy. Like, I already knew that it was going to slap with the production. But this one might be my favorite production-wise. I like it so much. I like it. Really like it. I wish it were longer. 2 minutes and 30 seconds was not long enough for this song. I feel like it should have been a little bit longer. Here we go with track number 7. A song y'all all know and love. Lost Cause. I still haven't heard this yet, but we're gonna listen to Lost Cause for the first time here and now. Let's get it. Oh, the bass. Oh, wait. I think I've seen a snippet of this on TikTok. This is the one where she was dancing with the girls in like her room, and it was very like bright and pretty, and they was doing choreo. I saw that. I seen that.
But maybe that's fine. You weren't even there that day. I was waiting on you. I was wrong. You were nothing but a lost cause. And this ain't nothing like it once was.
I love how clear her voice is in this song.
But a lost cause. And this ain't nothing like it once was. But that was way before I realized someone like you would always be so easy to find. Would have grown eventually, but you proved me wrong. You ain't nothing but a lost cause.
Oh, background. I like this one. I like the background on this one a lot too. Okay, we're gonna move on to track number 8, Halley's Comet. Halley's Comet, I'm not sure how it's pronounced. Sounds pretty.
I don't want it. And I don't. Must admit you've been in quite a few.
Ooh.
Haley, make a promise. Silly me to fall in love with you.
Haley's Comet, or Comet Halley, officially designated 1P/Halley, is a short period comet visible from Earth every 75 to 76 years.
I haven't slept since Sunday. Midnight for me is 3 a.m. 4, but right now, in this moment, I feel more and more like I was made for you.
Uh-oh, I hear the drone. Oh, a little transition.
I'm sitting in my brother's room. What am I to do?
My initial thought was, this second part, like this very last little part that she gave us, sounded so pretty that I kind of wish she didn't have that filter on her voice. And then, to take it a step further, I wish that it would have been a little bit longer. She only gives us 4 lines in this very last part. I'm sitting in my brother's room, haven't slept in a week or two. I think I might have fallen in love. What am I to do? Nonetheless, the entire song is pretty. Track number 9, Not My Responsibility. Let's go.
Do you know me? Really know me? You have opinions about my opinions, about my music, about my clothes, about my body.
Speak on it as she should, because y'all, well, not like y'all the ones watching, but a lot of people were very weird commenting. Just in general, you shouldn't comment about people's bodies. Like, I thought we knew better, but I guess a lot of people don't. But an underage girl's body, especially at the time when she was underage, and then she became of age, and people thought that it was okay to make the comments that they were making, but like, still, you shouldn't be saying the things that you were saying. Weird. Weird, methinks.
Some people hate what I wear. Some people praise it. Some people use it to shame others. Some people use it to shame me. And nothing I do goes unseen. So while I feel your stares, your disapproval, do my shoulders provoke you? Does my chest? Am I my stomach? If I shed the layers, I'm a slut. We make assumptions about people based on their size. We decide who they are. We decide what they're worth. Is my value based only on your perception? Or is your opinion of me not my responsibility?
She just absolutely spoke 100% facts. Wow. 100%. Everything she said was so valid. I'm not gonna go on the whole rant because I'm ready to get to the next song. But fans don't really treat their faves, or not even just fans, but people don't treat celebrities like people. They don't see that same thing that they see in their mom, their brother, their dad, their sister, their auntie, their uncle, their nephew, their niece, their cousin. They don't see that in celebrities. Like, it's so easy to judge a celebrity, and I don't understand how it became that way, why they think that just because a celebrity is in the public eye that it's okay to shame them, bash them, talk however you want to them. And I think it's because they know that since celebrities are so high up and have such a huge following and have just, you know, so many things to do, that they're not gonna see what you're saying, but they see a lot of it. And then they get mad when you have people like Cardi B who will clap back. We see, that's new. We don't have a lot of people that clap back. That's a very new thing. Usually people will do what Billie just did. They'll talk about it in music. They put it in their art. Well, now you have people like Cardi B, and Lil Nas, who will make you uncomfortable by replying to what you said. Just because she's a celebrity doesn't mean you can say whatever you want to her and she'll let it slide. Like, she definitely will find your tweet and she'll quote reply it, dragging you. I think people need to just start realizing that, you know, celebrities are people. Anyways, track number 10, Overheated. Production. Just kick. This is sick.
I'm overheated. I kinda don't care. You wanna kill me. You wanna hurt me. Stop being flirty. It's kinda working. Did you really think this is the right?
Come on, Billy.
Heated. Can't be defeated. Can't be deleted.
This chorus is sick. This chorus is so sick. I'm overheated. Can't be defeated, can't be deleted, can't unrelieve it. Like, oh, she's so sick.
I'm overheated. Can't be defeated.
Defeated.
Can't be deleted.
Can't be deleted.
Can't unbelieve it.
No.
And everybody said it was a letdown. I was only bad like everybody else. But I didn't get a surgery.
Oh, she's spitting? She a rapper? Yeah! She's spitting. She wanna be a rapper. Look like we got a new queen of rap.
Shout.
Let me stop. I'm joking. These are just jokes. Nobody take it seriously. But seriously, she starts spitting.
And everybody said it was a letdown. I was only bad like everybody else. But I didn't get a surgery to help. I'm in my bitches. It's none of my business. But don't you get sick. Posing for pictures. Can't be defeated.
For this last chorus, I wish she would have, because she be having ad-libs all through and through her songs, but I wish she would have had ad-libs right here, like what I was doing earlier, like the, I'm overheated, overheated, can't be defeated, can't be defeated, can't be deleted, like stuff like that. Like, I feel like it would have just made it even more sickerer than it already is.
Be deleted, can't be repeated, I'm overheated.
Yes, this is going to my top three, without a doubt. Stay until the end to find out what my top three is, if I'm able to, you know, actually give you one. Here we go with track number 11, Everybody Dies.
Everybody dies. Surprise, surprise.
Yes.
We might not be alone. Everybody dies. That's what they say. And maybe I just wonder why.
Come on.
Stay. If everybody don't wanna cry. Some days I do, but not about you. Like a child. It's not my fault. It's not so wrong to wonder why. You might not wanna go, but it's okay to cry, and it's alright to fall. You're not unknown.
Slightly annoyed, not with the song, but because I was so submersed and invested in the happier than ever world, but I got interrupted. My brother opened the door, started talking to me, and it took me out. So now I didn't get to pay as much attention to this specific song. Because I listened to it and it sounds pretty, but I really wasn't actively able to listen to it the same way that I would listen to the other songs. I hate when that happens. I hate when I get interrupted. Like, I should just put a sign on the door. Anyways, here we go with track number 12, Your Power.
She's got to get to class. How dare you find out if you could take it all back.
Oh, wait, what's the situation? Oh, it seems like it's like a grooming type of situation that she's explaining. She was sleeping in your clothes. Now she's got to get to class. So she's clearly a student. And this person is abusing their power. Is she talking about herself? I remember fans saying that, like, she dated a guy that was older than her. I don't know anything. So I don't want to just assume that she was groomed or anything. But I remember saying something like, she dated a 28-year-old or is dating someone that's way older than her? I don't know. Let me know if you know. Let me know what you know down in the comments below. Let's get back into the song.
And you swear you didn't know. You said you thought she was your age. How dare you wanna lose your power? But power isn't pain.
Okay, that was your power. That was heavy. That was real heavy. I was not expecting it to be like that. Here we go with track number 13, song we all know, NDA.
Did you think I'd show up in a limousine? No. Had to save my money for security. Got a stock of walking up and down the street. Yeah, I made him sign an NDA.
Production on this song is so infectious. I'm going to the very last part. The did I take it too far?
Did I take it too far? Don't know what you are. You're so high.
Yeah, that's an automatic banger. Here we go with track number 14, another song we all know and love, Therefore I Am. Hey. Oh wait, I forgot when I reacted to the music video, I noticed the transition. So I want to go back and hear it real quick. From NDA to Therefore I Am. Oh, that's so sick.
I'm not your friend or anything, damn. Stop. What the hell are you talking about? Get my pretty name out of your mouth. We are not the same with or without. I don't think I got your name.
This still a banger. And I love how she harmonizes.
I'm not your friend or anything, damn. You think that you're the man. I think therefore I am.
Still a banger. Here we go with track 15, the title track, Happier Than Ever.
When I'm away from you, I'm happier than ever.
Oh. It's not what I was expecting. I did not expect it to be like that. I thought it was going to be like, when I'm in your arms, sun beating down on us, driving through Sunset Boulevard, I'm happier than ever. She said, psych. No. When I'm away from you, I'm happier than ever.
I wish it wasn't true. Tell me what to do. When you said you were passing through, was I even on your way? And I tend to be more afraid. Don't say it isn't fair. You clearly weren't aware that happier than ever. You call me again, drunk. Ooh. In your Benz.
We just switched from very mellow and relaxed to like antsy, because it switched from, I want to say, I don't know if it was a ukulele. It was some type of stringed instrument, some type of guitar. But now we're moving to an electric guitar, which is what she wasn't using before. So we're about to amp it up. I can tell already. This switch was sick, by the way.
You scared me to death, but I'm wasting my breath. Cause you only listen to your fucking friends. I don't relate to you. You made me hate this city.
Ooh. She's not about to do that. She's not about to. Wow. I'm going to the beginning of part two of this song.
I don't relate to you. I don't relate to you, no. And I don't talk shit about you.
I'm in love with this. Yeah! I don't need, I'm gabberflasted, flabbergasted, shocked, confused, beside myself, out of my mind. Wow, this was excellent. Especially the second half. Like the song was good all through and through. But that second half is literally what sold me. Like, that might just be the best part of this entire album. She saved it for the title track. What a genius. Before I talk about the album, we're gonna listen to this very last song. Track number 16, Male Fantasy. Let's get it. Very folky.
Home alone, trying not to eat, distract myself with pornography. I hate the way satisfied is a male fantasy. I'm going back to therapy.
Come on.
Guess it's hard to know when nobody else comes around. Be alright, come in.
Exactly. I really like that she's singing most of this in her falsetto. I also really like the melodic lines that she's choosing. Like at the beginning, she did the da na na na.
Home alone, trying not to eat.
And that's so catchy. Like that progression, that melody, that pattern is so sick. It's so catchy, especially to me. Like I there's like a few different type of melodic patterns that I fall for, and this is like one of them. Like it's the same as the I walked across an empty. I don't even know if y'all know that song.
I walked across an empty land. I knew the pathway like the back of my hand.
The da-na-na-na, da-na-na-na. I love it.
I got a call from a girl I used to know. We were inseparable years ago. It's hard to know when nobody else comes around. Be alright, convince myself I hate you.
Whoever it is that she's talking about in these songs, whoever is like she went through this experience with, whoever she dated or, you know, talked to and then broke up with, clearly it's somebody that's still important to her. Because, and happier than ever, she said that she was happier than ever that she was away from that person. She was tired of being around that person. And now she's saying, like, the very last line, the closing line on the album, I know I should, but I could never hate you. So it seems like this person that she clearly doesn't like anymore, she can't hate them. They're still important to her, maybe. This was a solid album. All right, y'all. We just got done listening to Billie Eilish's second studio album titled Happier Than Ever. I'm impressed. I'm actually impressed with the maturity. Like, I knew that it was gonna sound more mature in general just because of the singles that we had gotten. But at the same time, I wasn't really expecting it to be like this drastic of a difference. Like, I feel like it's very different from When We All Fall Asleep, Where Do We Go? And I don't think that's an immature album, but I really do feel like she leveled up. Now, when it comes to songs in general, like songs that I would play, I do feel like I would go back to When We All Fall Asleep, Where Do We Go? More because she has more like upbeat, banger type of songs on there. But like, these songs are, if I had to put it in simple terms, I would say like When We All Fall Asleep, Where Do We Go is for like the fans who go to her live concerts, and those are the songs that they want to hear, and those are the bangers and the bops and all that. And then you have this new album, which is for Billie herself, of course, and then for like fans who want to know more about her life and more about the things she went through and that type of stuff. Like, this one is very much more the intimate and personal album, and I like that because it shows growth in so many different ways. Her writing, the production, I feel like the production was, there was a wide variety on this album. And then the topics that she talked about, you know, like the one that really stuck out was the situation about the grooming. She talked about fans and her boundaries and how they're not really respected by just people in general, and her body, and she was really sexual, talking about her relationships. Like, I really liked it. It was really good. Like, if I had to pick the better album, I would pick this one simply because of the theme and the story and the maturity of it all. But if I had to go, like, you know, for a drive and then listen to bangers, I would probably listen to When We All Fall Asleep first, if that makes sense. But I can honestly say this is the better album. Thematically. Do I want to try to pick a top three? I don't know, but I can tell you the songs that I saved. I'm gonna tell you all the songs that I saved real quick. So out of the 16 songs that we have, I saved 12 of them, and then 4 of them I did not save. So I'm gonna go and say all the ones that I did save. I didn't change my number: Billie Bossa Nova, Goldwing, Lost Cause, NDA, Halley's Comet, Not My Responsibility, Overheated, Your Power, Therefore I Am, Happier Than Ever, and Male Fantasy. And then the songs that I did not save are Getting Older, My Future, Oxytocin, and then Everybody Dies. If I had to pick a top three, and what you need to do is follow me on Twitter, because I keep changing my top threes, and then Twitter gets more refined and more refined and more accurate. But this is just off the first listen. My top three off of the first listen are, and this is in no particular order, Billie Bossa Nova for sure. Happier Than Ever, for sure. And now, I don't know if I want to do Overheated or Goldwing, because the choir-ish sound in Goldwing was sick, but then the chorus in Overheated was sick as well. I'm going to have to... It's a tie. Goldwing and Overheated are tied for the last songs in my top three. I don't know. And as I listen more, I'll be more refined, and I'll kick one of them out. But yeah, those are my top three songs. Let me know what you think. Give me your opinions. But make sure you comment down below your top three. Comment down below how you feel about the songs, which songs you like, which songs you didn't like. Tell me about some of these situations. Like, I want to know if the grooming thing or, you know, the... Like, I want to know what happened, because I'm not really invested, so I didn't know what went down. Yeah, but especially tell me more about like how you feel about the album. I want to know what songs you like, what songs you dislike, and I want to see your top three. Make sure you like, follow me on my social medias, they're right here and linked in the description below. Subscribe, share with your friends, and then take it a step further and click the notification bell so you are always notified when I post brand new Billie Eilish content, whether it's new music videos, another new album, live performances, or whatever y'all comment that y'all want me to react to next. Thank you so much for watching. I love y'all, and I hope y'all enjoyed the video. I will catch you in the next one. Peace.